Morning, students. Hope you're fine. And we have completed with one chapter of language, which is noun. And we'll be moving to the next after we complete one chapter of literature, right? So today we are going to start with literature. You have to take your books with you and a pencil in your hand, right? I'll be explaining the chapter. Then certain words I'll be making you mark where you are going to find the meanings also. And I'll also tell you the meanings, but I'll send another picture of the words, of the meanings that you have to write in the book. Clear? So we are going to open the first chapter, which is the open window, right? Which is the open window. So let's start with it. Now, before starting, coming to the entire chapter, suppose one of your friend has come to meet you, okay? And you try to play a game with him, trick him or her, by scaring him and telling him a story about a ghost, and you're framing the story by yourself, then what would be the effect of this on your friend? What would be the effect? There can be one, he can get scared, right? Definitely he'll get scared if he's not, if he's fearful of the ghost, he will definitely get scared. And second thing, he might run, he might cry, he might start shouting. Or it can even have a long lasting impact, right? Where he starts believing in this ghost and he gets scared and this fear stays in him forever, right? These three things can happen. Similarly, we are going to study this in this chapter, where there are two characters, right? One is Vera, a girl of 15, and other is Mr. Nuttall, right? And he is a man who is eccentric hypochondriac. Eccentric, which means strange. Hypochondriac means he is a person who is always worried about his health. Right? He's always worried about his health. And if I talk about Vera, the way you behaved with your friend, Vera also behaved the same way with Mr. Nuttall. His full name is Frampton Nuttall. Okay. So Vera is very good in telling stories and she's very mischievous. Now let us read the story. Read the story where a nervous young man, who's this nervous young man? Frampton Nuttall, falls prey. Prey means, say for example, a lion eats a deer. So deer is the prey for lion, right? Similarly, Mr. Nuttall is the prey, becomes the prey of Vera and her story, to a trick that leaves him at his wit's end. Wit's end means the ability to use a word in a cleverest and a humorous way. So Vera has this quality that she uses words in such a way that Mr. Nuttall falls into her trick, right? Now see, my aunt will be down presently, Mr. Nuttall, said a very self-possessed young lady of 15. Self-possessed means the girl who is very confident, who is very calm. So she said that the story starts with Mr. Nuttall has a nervous disorder, right? And the doctor has advised him that he should go and stay in countryside so that his nerve ailment or nerve disease can be cured. Now, on his doctor's advice, he goes to the countryside, and he goes to a place where his sister has already lived. Okay, so she gives him a brief introduction of the neighbors, so in the form of a letter, and so he founds one of the letter and he visits one of the neighbor who's Mrs. Sappleton. And when he goes to the countryside, Mrs. Sappleton is not available. So her niece Vera, she greets him. Now she's a host who's welcoming Mr. Nuttall. Now see, my aunt will be down presently. Now whose aunt? Vera's aunt, and that is Mrs. Sappleton. Will be down presently means she'll be here in a while, Mr. Nuttall, and said a very self-possessed young lady. So young lady is Vera, who's welcoming Mr. Nuttall, and she's saying, my aunt will be while until the time she comes. Meanwhile, you have to put up with me. That means you have to tolerate me. Meantime means while Mrs. Sappleton is not available, till the time I'm your host and I'm going to welcome you and you have to tolerate me. So, and try to put up with me. Put up means tolerate. Frampton Nuttall endeavored to say the correct something which would duly flatter the niece of the moment without unduly discounting the aunt that was to come. So Frampton Nuttall tried to say something that he could flatter her, flatter or praise, praise or praising the girl to please her, to make her happy, make happy the host. Who's the host? Now Vera, the niece of Mrs. Sappleton. And without going beyond, he tries that till the time the aunt comes, he is able to have a communication with with Vera. But privately, means he himself believed that he had a doubt more than ever whether these formal visits on succession. Succession means a group of people or things that are arranged following in an order, when things are happening. So he says, if I go and meet strangers in a new place, how can this help cure my nerve disease? So he says that this is not possible. But privately, he believes that this is not possible. Now, is the first page clear? Now, let us come to the second page. It will be, his sister had said. I know how it will be. He know, she, his sister. Now, his sister is, Mr. Nuttall's sister said, I know. How will you go and stay there in the countryside? When he was preparing to migrate to his rural retreat. Rural retreat means when he was migrating. Migrating means moving from one place to another. So when he was preparing and moving from one place to another and going to the countryside to stay. At that time, his sister said, I know how you're going to behave. You are a person who will bury yourself down there. Bury yourself down there means you're going to stay alone with yourself and not speak to a living soul. Living soul means any human being. You're not going to go and talk with any human being, and you're going to stay within yourself only. And your nerves will worse than ever from moping. And instead of your this nerve cure which you have, which you want to have, and you're going there for, will instead of getting better will become more worse, and it would make you feel more dejected. I should just give you letters of introduction. I'll give you the letter of introduction where I'm writing the letter of the people I know there. So the neighbor, since she has visited that place, she's lived in that place. So she's saying, I'm giving you a letter of introduction about few people that I know there. And some of them, as far as I can remember, were quite nice. And some of them are very nice. Now, Frampton Nuttall wondered whether Mrs. Sappleton, the lady to whom he was presenting one of the letters of introduction, came into the nice division. Now he thought that he's meeting is Mrs. Sappleton. Now whether she's a good lady, she's a good person, human being. Do you know many of the people around here? Asked niece. Now who's the niece? Vera. Okay, so Vera is asking to Mr. Frampton Nuttall that, do you know many people out there, the place that you have come? Do you know many people? When she judged that they had sufficient silent communication, when they were getting bored with each other, they were not able to communicate. So she tried to communicate and she said, do you know more any people around here in this place? Hardly a soul, said Frampton. Frampton said, hardly anyone I know. My sister was staying here at the rectory. So he's saying, my sister used to stay over here at the rectory. Now, what is rectory? It's the house of a senior church official. So it can be shown like this. This is called as rectory, right? Now, is it clear? Now, let's move ahead. You know, some 4 years ago, she gave me letters of introduction to some of the people here. So she said, 4 years ago, she gave me the letter of introduction about the neighbors. And while I was coming here, he made the last statement in a tone of distinct regret. Regret means sadness, which is associated with disappointment. And he was not happy in coming in because he didn't believe that this thing could help him cure his disease. He made the last then you know practically nothing about my aunt, pursued the self-possessed young lady. Now who's the self-possessed young lady? Vera. Now she's saying, then you might not be knowing anything about my aunt. Pursued means continued saying. So she continued that you might not be knowing much about my aunt then. So only her name and address, admitted the caller. Now who's the caller over? Who's giving the answer? Mr. Nuttall. So he's saying, yes, I only know her name and the address. He was wondering whether Mrs. Sappleton was in the married or widowed state. Now he was thinking whether Mrs. Sappleton is married or she's not. Now this entire scene is being done in the house of Mrs. Sappleton. An undefinable something about the room seemed to suggest masculine habitation. See, generally habitation means act of living in a particular place. If I'm living in my place, this is my habitation. My home is my habitation. But now he's saying that the place suggested it was masculine habitation. That means that place suggested that man had lived in that particular place. There were things that suggested that man lived there. Now she started. The child, who's the child? The niece or the self-possessed woman, lady of 15, that is Vera. Her great tragedy happened just 3 years ago. Now she's saying 3 years ago, she's continuing and she's saying that 3 years ago, you know, a bad tragedy has taken place with my aunt. Tragedy means something, an event that has caused huge loss, right? Her tragedy, asked Mr. Frampton. Frampton asked, a tragedy with her? Somehow in this restful country, spot tragedy seemed out of place. He says, in such a peaceful and place, I don't think tragedies could happen. But then she again continued, you may wonder, we keep that window wide open on the October afternoon, said the niece, indicating a large French window that opened onto a lawn. See, you can even see it in the picture also. In the picture also, that there's a French window and it is open. See, if I show you, I'll show you. This is kind of a French window. This is kind of a French window. And if the door is open, then she used to keep the door open. And now she's going to explain why the door was kept open and there was a lawn. You can also see in the picture at the back, if the door gets open, there's a huge lawn. Now, you may wonder why we keep the window wide open. Now, he's saying you might be wondering why this window is being open and which month has been talked of? October and afternoon, said the niece, indicating a large French window that opened to a lawn. So, this is the French. So, this is the French window. This is the French window. This is the French window that has been talked and the door remained open. It is quite warm for the time of the year. Now, the October month has been described that it is the warm month of the year, said Frampton. Now, he's talking and saying, yes, it's the warm month. That is why she might have opened the window, because it's little summer. But as the window has got anything to do with the tragedy? Now, he's saying, has this window also got to do something with the tragedy that took place? Now, she's continuing further. Out through that window, 3 years ago, to a day means today. That same day, 3 years ago, that her husband and her two young brothers, Mrs. Sappleton's husband, that is Mr. Sappleton, and Mrs. Sappleton's two younger brothers, they all have gone for day's shooting. So they have gone for shooting during the day. They never came back. But the sad thing is that they never came back. In crossing the moor to their favorite snipe shooting ground. Now, while they were going to the place, this is moor. So, a large bushy place covered with green bushes. So, this is kind of a moor, right? So, he's saying that while they went to cross the moor and then they went to this snipe shooting ground. Snipe shooting ground is a place where people are hunted and killed. And from such a place where you cannot be seen. Okay. Then they were all three engulfed in a treacherous piece of bog. Now he's saying that they were all engulfed. Engulfed means completely surrounded or covered with a treacherous, dangerous piece of bog. Now this is a picture of a bog and it was very dangerous. And now he's saying they were completely engulfed in this, completely covered in this bog. It had been dreadful and it was very sad. It was very terrible that summer. You know, and places that were safe in the year gave way suddenly without warning. Even at that time, the places which were good, they all became very dangerous. Their bodies were never recovered. But the sad thing is, till today, their bodies have not been recovered. That was the dreadful part. Now, the saddest part, the terrible part is that their body has not been recovered. Here's a child who has lost its self-possessed note. Till the time, she was very calm, composed. But now when she was explaining this, she lowered her tone and tried to give the impression that she's actually being sad and became faltering human. Faltering means his voice now indicating that she's feeling sad. Her voice was hesitant. She was hesitant to speak now. Poor aunt always thinks that they will come back someday. Now she's giving that aunt. She feels that they would come back someday. All three of them. Sorry. Would come back. They and the little brown spaniel. Now, what is little brown spaniel? This is a dog that accompanied them. Can you see that? This is the spaniel, little brown spaniel, the dog that accompanied them for the shooting. And he was also lost with them. And she believed that all four of them, now the three people, that is her husband, Mr. Sappleton, and the two brothers, along with this dog, would return back. This is why the window is kept open every evening till it is quite dusk. So every day this window is kept open because she hopes that they would return It is open till it is very quiet. Till it is quite dusk, it is quite dark. Dusk means dark. Poor dear aunt, she has often told me how they went out. And then she has often told me how they used to go out, her husband and her white waterproof coat over his arm. So since it could rain anytime, so he used to wear a waterproof coat. And Ronnie, her youngest brother, singing, "Bertie, why do you moan?" Now, the name of her youngest brother is Ronnie. And he used to sing a song for his brother, for his sister, that used to annoy her. And the song was, "Bertie, why do you bound?" And he used to sing her to tease her. That means to make fun of her. Because she had it got on her nerves. She used to become very angry when he used to sing such a song. "Do you know, sometimes on still, quiet evenings like this, I almost get a creepy feeling." Now she's saying that even today, I get such a feeling that maybe one day, they would all walk in through the window. That one day from this window, they all will come back. Now, who all will come back? Yes, Mrs. Appleton and the two younger brothers. One of the name has been mentioned as the Ronnie, who was the youngest brother. And the dog, the name of the dog, what is the dog? The brown spaniel, that he would also return back with them. And aunt believes that they would come back. Now, after this, we'll continue the chapter again tomorrow in the next video. Till then, I'll be sending you the word meanings that you have to write and the words that you have to find and write it over there. Then the question answers. Now what will you do in the literature notebook? You will write down the word meanings that are being sent to you and the question with the black pen and answer with the blue pen. Clear? Thank you.